everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I heard Art, I heard Nick. I didn't hear anybody else.
I said good morning.
I heard James, yes, of course. Good morning, everybody. All right. Thank you all for traveling great distances to come and experience the all-new Optima. We're very excited about it. And as Scott mentioned, this is really going to be anything but ordinary over the next day. And that's true to what the Kia brand really stands for. We consider ourselves a challenger brand, constantly challenging traditional automotive convention, whether it's from a design standpoint, from a technology standpoint, or a marketing standpoint. So a lot of parallels between the Kia brand and Aspen. Now, our sales have been anything but ordinary. We've had our best first half of the year. In September, we sold over 49,000 vehicles, up 22% over last September, which led us then to our best third quarter ever. And we're on track, knock on wood, to have our best year ever. So very excited with the next couple of months of what is ahead of us. Our sales have outpaced the industry. We're up 7% for the year. The industry's up about 5%. And in spite of the industry, a lot of it's being driven by trucks, which, as you know, we do not, we don't participate in that. So a lot of momentum for the brand, eighth largest brand in the U.S., and over 40% of our sales are coming from our two products built down in West Point, Georgia, one being the Optima and the other being the Sorento. All right. Now, here's just some of the awards and accolades that we've seen over the last year. So it's not, again, not anything but ordinary. It's extraordinary in terms of what we've been receiving from a lot of the publications that you represent. And it's not just individual products. We've got Soul, Forte, K900, Sedona, all of our products are receiving great awards and accolades. The corporation is also receiving them as well. And it's, again, it's product, it's marketing, it's technology, it's everything. So we appreciate that we're finally being recognized for the great things that we've been doing. In terms of other things that are anything but ordinary, this is one of my favorite slides to show. Back in 2001, Kia was at the very bottom of the J.D. Power IQS study. The bottom, dead last. And a mere 14 years later, we rose to the top. Second behind just Porsche, number one in mainstream brands. 14 years with just a dedicated focus on quality. And that just, again, speaks to the Kia brand. We challenge the traditional automotive convention. Along the way, people said we couldn't do it, and we did. There's seven brands up there that were on the list back in 2001. They're no longer even here in the United States. And I know back in 2001, there was some skepticism of whether how long the Kia brand would last. But we've proven the skeptics wrong, and you're gonna see a lot of the quality in this vehicle later today. But it's not just J.D. Power that's talking about the quality. Strategic Vision has named the Optima highest in its total quality index. Consumer Reports has put us in the top 10 brands in terms of reliability. From a customer satisfaction standpoint, we're ahead of Honda, Nissan, Subaru, Ford, and Mazda, according to J.D. Power. So a lot of things all coming together. The J.D. Power really kind of being the tipping point for what we're calling the new Kia. Part of the new Kia is going to be our second manufacturing plant here in North America. We're building it down in Monterrey, Mexico. It'll begin production of the Forte in mid-2016. And, you know, this is part of our strategy to continue to grow here in the United States. We continue to see huge opportunities for the Kia brand, particularly as more and more customers are discovering this great brand. We've also, in terms of part of our continuous improvement, we've hired Albert Bierman from BMW. He's really focusing on the performance aspects of our vehicles. You will experience some of that today. So a great hire to really complete. We've got Peter Schreier on the design. We've got great technology, great safety. Now we're going to have even better performance than what we already have. Our plans going forward is we've planned to introduce about 22 all new or significantly redesigned products over the next 5 years. For those of you who went to Frankfurt, you got to see the first of that. That would be the Sportage, which we'll introduce at the LA Auto Show here in the United States. That'll be followed by a new hybrid and plug-in hybrid for the Optima models. We're not going to talk about those today. We're going to focus on the gas models here, but stay tuned for more information on that in early 2016. And then, of course, we'll have many more models to introduce over the next 5 years. So our growth will continue. Now, for us to talk about the new Optima, it makes sense for us to talk a little bit about the old Optima and the impact that it had on our brand. It really was the turning point when we introduced the vehicle at the New York Auto Show back in 2010. And for those of you that were there, you may remember we talked about the Optima being the car that without a doubt would take Kia to the next level. And it was actually probably an understatement when we made that remark. In fact, many of you may remember when Blake Griffin jumped over the Optima, it really kind of was the shot or the scene heard around and seen around the world. The Optima has been our best seller for the last 3 years. It was the first Kia vehicle to sell over 150,000 vehicles, and it has consistently over the last 3 years. Sales are up over 480% from when we first introduced it. Back in 2009, we sold 25,000 Optimas. So again, this vehicle is really anything but ordinary. The design really lends itself to be shown in a lot of different ways. We've had it at SEMA. It's been featured in many different campaigns. The hybrid got a Guinness World Record. It's really been an exciting product for us, and again, really made a strong statement for the brand. It's been a central part of our motorsports strategy. You may remember about 6 years ago, we started with the Forte Coupes, and when we got the Optima, we said, wow, this is a vehicle that we think will do very well on the racetrack. In fact, so well last year, it won the 2014 Pirelli World Challenge. So very exciting to see that. It's also been featured in a number of our Super Bowl spots. And for those of you who may remember, we, again, take a different approach to our marketing. We don't just generally show kind of the traditional way of showing a car going down a leafy highway, leaves blowing in the air. We take a different approach to really kind of set ourselves apart from the mainstream. So this is the new Optima. We're ready to change the game again, and Orth is going to come up in just a little bit to talk about it. Again, a very exciting product for us. We expect it to take us even higher than where we already are. To launch this vehicle, we're going to go back to the Super Bowl, back to the world's biggest marketing stage. We'll be up at the 50th Super Bowl in San Francisco with a 60-second spot featuring the Optima. But before we do that, we're actually going to kind of pre-launch the vehicle in the next couple of months with our partnership with the NBA and Blake Griffin. And we've got a campaign called Get in the Zone. And for those of you who are sports fanatics or into sports, you know that top elite athletes talk about being in the zone, kind of that metaphysical state where they're really intense. There's skills and performance at a level that nobody else can achieve or understand. They're at their top performance. So we're taking this idea and lending itself to the Optima so that when you're driving the new Optima, you're kind of in that zone. It's going to put you in your peak performance, and you'll have a great experience with that. So